claims of vandalism in the battle for the North Shore State Senate seat.
As Shelby Croft reports, new at 10, one candidate says dozens of campaign signs were taken or vandalized over the 4th of July holiday.
Could Senator Darling count on your vote?
Alberta Darling's headquarters is buzzing with volunteers making calls and buzzing about what happened to those throwing their support behind Darling.
He said, "Your signs are gone." I said, "What?" He said, "Yeah, your signs are gone."
State Senator Darling got the news from a friend. Her signs throughout the North Shore, Whitefish Bay in particular, had been pulled or vandalized.
The whole thing seems to be getting very much into bullying and intimidation tactics, starting, continuing from the Capitol.
Darling supporter Patty Ryman placed many of the signs herself. Her yard was one of those targeted.
I know where all the good Republican yards are, so I know that they are not happy that their signs are down.
Okay, and I have your vote.
Yes, you do.
Sandy Pash is hoofing it in Mequon, drumming up support. Darling's opponent in the state Senate recall thinks signs are targeted every election.
It's unfortunate that it happens, but it seems to be happening on both sides.
Pash calls it a distraction from the issues.
We need to come together, not throw more fuel on the fire of the divisiveness of our state and the politics that are going on.
With blocks equally split on who they support, some North Shore neighbors would like to see a little more civility.
I'd say it's getting a little bit, a little nasty. It's unfortunate. I think both sides are taking it personal. I think we should all just tone it down a bit and, fight for your cause, but then at the end of the day, get over it.
We spoke with Whitefish Bay Police. They say that they've had a few reports of signs being swiped, but they think this is nothing really out of the ordinary for an election.